What's going on, everyone? Rabid here, and today we are checking out how much this Antminer L3 Plus has made us so far. So typically the profits, it's a little over 1 month. I put this on the 9th and now it's the 13th. So it's about 4 days over a month. So about 35 days is the profitability. We're gonna look at how much this thing has made for us since we had this thing online. Don't forget, be sure to subscribe, like, and hit that bell notification button to be notified for future videos, and help share my videos around the Reddit and YouTube world so that everyone does know we are back. I would also like to ask you guys, let me know in the comments below, are you mining with GPUs? Are you mining with CPUs? Or are you mining with Antminers or any other ASIC, as well as the firmware you are possibly using on your ASIC? Like I've said in previous videos, I am now using Hive on firmware on this ASIC. It's only running at 660 watts, still running 504 megahash on the scrypt algorithms, and I am profit switching using the pro hashing pool. So are you guys running the same type of configuration, or are you guys doing something else? Let me know in the comments below, please. Before I actually get into some profits here, I noticed when I did my last video on the Antminer L3 Plus, a lot of people were talking about, oh, well, they have an L3 Plus, so it's a little better. Well, yes and no. Looking at the L3 Plus, it's saying it's doing 596 megahash, which, yes, is more, at 1,050 watts. Now, I did some numbers here, and that is not efficient. I think the L3 Plus is better than the L3 Plus efficiency-wise, and when it comes to crypto mining, that is what you want, efficiency. So the L3 Plus here, I went through the numbers, and it has an efficiency of 0.567 megahash per watt. So that is not too good. And right now, like I said, I am running in Hive OS. We were running 660 watts at 504 megahash. Now, the default value is 504 megahash at 700 watts. Now, that alone is already, just with the default, is 0.72 megahash per watt, up from 0.567 that the L3 Plus has. Now, I am running this at 660 watts at 504, and that is 0.763 megahash per watt. So the L3 Plus is extremely way more efficient than the L3 Plus. So try not to overspend. They caught you on saying, hey, look, this gives more megahash. A lot of people just look at the megahash number and say, hey, this is better. You know, you got to look at the efficiency. The name of the game is efficiency, not really megahash when it comes down to it, because you're just wasting money on power. Now here you can overclock this to even better values than the L3 Plus. Look at this, 610 megahash at 890 watts. That's even better than what the L3 Plus is predicted. We can get this thing up to 680 megahash at 1160 watts. Now, I'm still only running this at the 660 at 504, because as I go up on these, they become less and less efficient. Yes, you get a lot more megahash out of it, but each one of these is less efficient than running at this value. That is why I run this. I run everything at the highest hash to watt ratio. That way you maximize your profits and you're using the least amount of power possible. Okay, so let's get into these profits, because that's probably what all you guys are waiting for, or you just fast forward to this part already anyway. So I'm on pro hashing here. Here you can see I am profit switching. And what that means, it's merge mining. So here you can see I merge mine. So Dogecoin, Mydrid coin, it's doing some Floral coin, Emerald, Litecoin, all the way down. And over here we hit like a moon coin. So it is constantly swapping and merge mining different coins, everything that is scrypt algorithm based, because that's what the Antminer L3 Plus does mine, is scrypt based algorithms, and then you just get paid out in whatever you set it. I have mine set to Litecoin, so I'm getting paid out in Litecoin. Now I can swap this over to something else. So here's payouts here. I can just add a new payment option, and I can mine all the scrypt algorithms. I can get paid in straight Dogecoin if I want. I can get paid in like Ravencoin, Veriscoin, Yearn Finance if I want. Like, say here's Ravencoin. I can get paid in Ethereum. I can get paid in pretty much anything I would like, merge mining all the scrypt algorithms on this Antminer L3 Plus. And here's what we made so far. So it is saying year to date. So ever since I first turned this thing on to this pool, I've made $260.26 USD. Again, that's for 35 days about right now. We're averaging anywhere from 8, little over 8, sometimes high 7s. But the last 4 or 5 days, we have been down to only $5.83. So I don't know if the difficulty is going up, or it's just due to because crypto has been going down. That is a very good possibility here as well. But we are looking at $260.26 USD. So what could the ROI and everything be on this? Well, I got to convert this over to Canadian dollars, because me being from Canada here, that looks like $330 Canadian
per month. Well, a little over a month. And for an ROI, I see people on Kijiji and eBay and other places, they're selling this for about $2,000, which is about 6 months at the current prices right now to ROI this. Now, some people got a massive great deal last crypto winter there in what, 2017, 2018. People were selling these Antminer L3 Pluses for $200. So this thing would have ROI'd itself in 1 month. That's pretty insane. But right now, everything moves with the crypto prices. Prices are going up, and these things are very hard to find, and they are very expensive compared to what they used to be at previous times. Now, brand new, I can't remember what they were. I think they're around 15 to 3,000. Not 100% sure. They are a few years old now. They're not top-of-the-line equipment anymore, and as we know, Bitmain is releasing one this November. That's supposed to be like 19 of these for the power consumption of only four of them. So we are expecting the hash rate and difficulty across Litecoin and the scrypt algorithms to times 19 at least because of this. So mining farms are going to go up. Our profits are going to drop from the difficulty increase here on an Antminer L3 Plus. And I'd really love to get my hands on an L7. Is it L7? Yeah, the L7 Antminer, because that thing, I think that thing's going to be one of the best miners to date coming up for the next couple years. All right, guys. So that is the profits that I've seen on this Antminer L3 Plus so far. So let me know in the comments if you are mining with these, if you'd like to try one out, if you're looking for one, or what you are mining with, because I am curious to see what everyone is mining with and seeing what you guys' plans are for the future. Because I feel GPU mining is could be not really coming to an end, but it's going to be hurting pretty bad here whenever Ethereum does move to proof of stake. So I think it is time to start looking at other ways to mine crypto. This is a crypto mining channel, not a strictly GPU mining channel. So we're looking for the best ways to mine crypto on this channel. So thanks for watching, guys. Please hit that subscribe button, thumbs up button, bell notification, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Rabid out. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you haven't, please comment, subscribe, and like this video, as well as check out one of these other videos if you have not seen it yet. I do try to stream every Saturday and Sunday, so stay tuned for more future content.